Recording.
Just feels like a dream to me to find a school so true. And I know it's all in make believe when I picture a school like you. The one thing that I learned from you is that I can make my dreams come true. Someday when I wake up to find memories that float along in my mind, imagine how that could be. Imagine how that could be.
Just feels like a dream to me to find a school so true. And I know it's all in make believe when I picture a school like you. The one thing that I learned from you is that I can make my dreams come true. Someday when I wake up to find memories that float along in my mind, imagine how that could be. Imagine how that could be. Humanity, what makes us feel above high is we believe we
Good afternoon, everybody. Good afternoon to all present. Before we, start with the guest visit, I would just like to, revise the housekeeping rules. You are supposed to turn on your cameras, and the right to unmute has been taken away from you. So please use the chat section to type in your questions. Just the questions, please. And, you'll be getting time for that. So please, write in your questions. That's it. Okay. Thank you so much, children. The learning outcome for today's class is know about the greenhouse gases. Why is the temperature of the earth rising? And finding solutions to reduce global warming. It's very, very important that every chapter or every topic or everything that we do has a takeaway message. So the learning outcome is very, very important. So now I would welcome the speaker for today, Dr. Sunita Arya, PhD Zoology, specialization in entomology, endocrinology, and environmental science. She is an associate professor of Department of Zoology at Dayanand Girls PG College with 20 years of experience in teaching and research. She has been honored by many environmental societies. She has also been awarded as the Best Teacher Award by Bharat Vikas Parishad. She is also an executive member in Vigyan Bharati New Delhi, an assistant editor in Kamdhenu Kripa Monthly Magazine. So I would welcome our speaker for today to start the thing. All to you now, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you so much. I'm audible, ma'am?
Yes, yes.
Okay, thank you. And welcome, children. Welcome in a new session with new class, in class third. Before starting, I will not take much time because I am in a very odd place at this time. Some university examination is going on, and in between them, I am taking your class. So first, I will talk to about environment. So children, can you tell me what is environment?
Please write in your answers, children. Please write in.
Can you tell me what is environment? Anyone? No? Okay, let me. I will tell you. All physical surroundings where we are living, animals are living, plants are living, means that place, land, water, all physical means all biotic factor and abiotic factor are existing, that place are our environment. Okay? Means in one line we can say all physical surroundings of the earth is environment. And in environment there are so many layers: atmosphere, biosphere, lithosphere, hydrosphere. There are so many regions, so many areas are there. And in that greenhouse, you know what is greenhouse? Greenhouse effect, you are listening, greenhouse effect means increasing the temperature of earth day by day, or slowly enhancement of the temperature or increasing the temperature of the earth is known as green global warming. Means greenhouse effect. Why we are saying the greenhouse? Because our earth is like a glass house, we can say, like a glass house where solar energy comes and trapped by some gases and not go out. Means greenhouse effect. So some sunlight, you are seeing in this picture, some sunlight are entering on the earth, and after reflection, go back, some solar energy or some sunlight go back on the space, but on the earth, there are so many greenhouse gases. They trap that energy and increase our, that is essential for our temperature. So these greenhouse gases are very essential for our earth. But the increasement of these solar energy means the enhancement of the temperature is not very good for the earth, because if greenhouse gas will not exist on the earth, so temperature will go very low and we can't survive in low temperature. So greenhouse gases are essential for earth, and we can see these greenhouse gases are good for earth, like CO2 means carbon dioxide. You are listening, you are seeing, carbon dioxide is essential for earth, but in a accurate amount. Okay, not in much amount. It will increase. If carbon dioxide will increase, definitely it will create pollution. So greenhouse gases are beneficial, but in not balanced amount, it will be harmful for our earth. So we can say there are good greenhouse gases and greenhouse effect and bad greenhouse effect. Okay, next, ma'am. We are seeing these are the greenhouse gases, methane, okay, nitrous oxide, carbon dioxide, chlorofluorocarbon, carbon monoxide, sulfur dioxide. These are some greenhouse gases. And we are seeing chlorofluorocarbon. You know, this gas is mostly responsible for the ozone layer depletion. Now we will see ki what is ozone layer. In next slide, we will see the ozone layer. And chlorofluorocarbon is used in our was used in our refrigerator, in air condition. But nowadays we are using freon gas in place of chlorofluorocarbon, and that gas is useful or not very much harmful for our earth. So nowadays we are using freon gas in our air condition and our refrigerator or in any cool places like storage house, warehouses, also freon gases are using nowadays. But chlorofluorocarbon, where chlorofluorocarbon is used, that is very much harmful for our earth. How greenhouse gases warm our planet? We are seeing in this, these gases trap so much energy from the sun, and that will not, after radiation, that will not go on the our planet or our in space. So that will increase our temperature of our earth. So our temperature of earth will, when our temperature of the earth will increase, so it will create global warming, and that will be harmful for our life, our plant life, our animal life. Next, ma'am. Here we are seeing annual greenhouse gas emission by sector. There are so many sectors like electricity. We are seeing our so many malls are there, and that is using electricity and a big transformers, so many big generators. So all these appliances creating or liberating so many heat. So 25.6% temperature will increase due to emitting by the electric power stations. Industrial processes, 15.9% gases or temperature will increase by the industrial process. Transportation, in transportation, so many vehicles are using fossil fuel, means petrol, diesel, and they are vomiting so many harmful gases like carbon monoxide, carbon dioxide, and that will also create global warming or greenhouse effect. So many lands, biomass, we are fossil fuel we are burning, and same thing we are burning our biomass, so that will also create the greenhouse effect and increase the temperature of earth. Next, ma'am. What is the importance of human produced greenhouse gases? Means earlier I have said the importance of greenhouse gases. These ground greenhouse gases are important because this diagram is showing the relative importance of the major human produced greenhouse gases in current warming. You are seeing this, the sunlight is coming on our planet Earth, and after radiation it is emitting and go out, and after that then again it comes in the temperature. So this is the process of trapping energy by our gases. So it will create that, it will increase the temperature of earth. So CO2 is the most important, and following the descending order by the methane, chlorofluorocarbon, ozone and nitrous oxide. So carbon dioxide is the most important gas for the greenhouse gas, and if we will not, and it is trapped, so carbon dioxide will trap by our plants. You know, जैसे हम लोग सांस लेते हैं तो हम लोग ऑक्सीजन, वी आर यूजिंग ऑक्सीजन फॉर ब्रीदिंग. तो सेम थिंग फॉर द प्रिपरेशन ऑफ फूड, वी आर डिपेंड ऑन द प्लांट्स फॉर द फूड एंड द प्लांट्स विल प्रिपेयर द फूड बाय द कार्बन डाइऑक्साइड इन द प्रेजेंस ऑफ सनलाइट. सो plants used carbon dioxide and we are liberating carbon dioxide when we are breathing. In breathing process we are using CO2, we are using oxygen from the plant, we are getting oxygen from the plant and liberating CO2, and then plants will absorb the and use the carbon dioxide, that carbon dioxide used, and they prepared food for us. So what we have to do for the protection, we have to plantation more and more for the save our planet. This is the only way that by that we can save our planet, by the increasement of these chlorofluorocarbon or carbon dioxide or nitrous oxide. This is the only way from that we can save our earth planet. Next slide, ma'am. This is the structure of chlorofluorocarbon. Means when you will come in big classes, then you will study the structure of atoms and molecules. Here you are seeing green balls, yellow balls, and black balls. These balls are indicating the chloro means chlorine, fluoro means fluorine, and carbon. So chlorine, fluorine, and carbon's atoms are when they will accumulate with and join all together and will create chlorofluorocarbon, and that will be a harmful gas for us. Here chlorofluorocarbons, you are seeing in the slide, humans have produced harmful chemicals that damage the ozone layer, and these chemicals are called chlorofluorocarbon. And these from where these chlorofluorocarbons will come, these chlorofluorocarbons will come from our refrigerator, our air condition, our big warehouses, industrial waste, and aerosol. These are the big source of chlorofluorocarbon, and now we are getting so much we are aware, and that's why we are using freon gas in place of chlorofluorocarbon and trying to minimize the effect of chlorofluorocarbon, and by that that's why our ozone layer was healing nowadays. Next slide, ma'am. Now we comes on the ozone layer. Do you know what is ozone layer? A layer on the earth, like umbrella. We can say a sunscreen. Umbrella, ozone layer is act like a sunscreen for us, or like umbrella for us. Why? This is a layer upon 50 kilometer above the our earth, our planet. The length of these distance is increasing or decreasing place to place, and this is the lunar air pollution, and after that ozone depletion or ozone layer, and global air pollution we are seeing in this in this slide. So ozone layer depletion, what is ozone layer depletion? In some places these ozone, and what is ozone? First of all we are saying what is ozone. Ozone means three molecules of oxygen. When three molecules of oxygen combined with each other, they will create ozone, and these ozone are upper on the above surface and protect from the ultraviolet rays or some harmful rays which comes from the sun to the earth. So we are using this ozone layer like the umbrella. But what happens? What is ozone depletion? These gases are being taking reaction with some other gases like chlorofluorocarbon. So this is making some other molecules, and ozone layer was thinning day by day. So many places has the minimum layer. That process is called ozone layer depletion. Next slide, ma'am. And what happens due to ozone layer depletion? Ultraviolet rays comes on the earth. So many after radiation, it will not go out, and due to global warming, our earth will become like a fireball. It is in temperature is increasing day by day, and that's why our earth being hot, and this is called global warming. And what is the effect of global warming? Due to global warming or greenhouse effect, our plants, our forests are degrading day by day. We are also affecting, so many animals are getting affected by the global warming, and they are decaying. Proper food setting, proper seed setting is not being done. Okay? So many plants, our temperature is responsible for the flowering, for the fruiting. So due to high temperature, food setting is not done, flowering is not done, and we are lacking rain. So there are these are the great effect of climate change. Okay, so global warming affect the climate change, and we are suffering nowadays climate change. And we are seeing also nowadays it is too hot. This is the rainy season. Nowadays, July, August is a rainy season. But here are no so much rain. Why? This is the effect of climate change. And there are some places or more of the places, there's too much heavy rain. So it is also a effect of climate change. So it means कहीं पर तो बहुत पानी है, जहां पर पानी की आवश्यकता नहीं है वहां बहुत पानी बरस रहा है, कहीं पर बहुत ठंडा हो रहा है, कहीं पर बहुत गर्म हो रहा है. तो इन सारे मौसम के परिवर्तन को जो हम लोग देख रहे हैं कि क्लाइमेट चेंजेस हो रहे हैं, तो इसको हम लोग कहते हैं इफेक्ट है हमारा ग्लोबल वार्मिंग का, ग्रीन हाउस इफेक्ट का और पोल्यूशन का. दीज आर द इफेक्ट ऑफ पोल्यूशन एंड ग्लोबल वार्मिंग. हमारी फसलें हम लोग देखते हैं खेतों में, आप लोग जानते हैं हम लोग जो फूड लेते हैं, ग्रेन्स लेते हैं, गेहूं खाते हैं, गेहूं से हमारा फ्लोर बनता है और उससे हमारी ब्रेड बनती है, रोटी बनती है. तो उसमें प्रॉपर गेहूं अगर टेम्परेचर हाई हो जाएगा तो वो गेहूं नहीं बनेगा. जब गेहूं नहीं होगा, चावल नहीं होगा, तो वॉट वी विल टेक, वॉट वी विल ईट. सो इट इज द इफेक्ट ऑफ ग्लोबल वार्मिंग. Next slide, ma'am. Here we are seeing what is the reason of global warming or ozone layer depletion. Here so many industries you are seeing in this picture, so many industries, so many pollution, so many garbage, so many things are here which are creating the ozone layer depletion, and these factors are responsible for the global warming. Next slide, ma'am. Global warming effect. Jaisa aapne bataya abhi, earlier I have said what is the effect of global warming. Due to global warming, our glaciers will melt. And from there, so many water will come on the plains, and our river will flood it, and we will be submerged on the water. So the low level area means our water level will increase and our earth will submerged or immersed on that water. So this is the big threat of the global warming. And another effect I have told, our agriculture, our food, our fruits, our animals, they all will get affected by this global warming. So we are seeing each day new greenhouse gas emission further accelerated these physical changes. So these are the effect of global warming. Next slide, ma'am. A big threat we are seeing, and very recently it happened, natural disaster. Recently we have seen in Uttarakhand, glaciers burst, and after that so many things will destroyed in this flood or in this disaster. So it is the effect of global warming. So everyone has seen it will happen on 7th February 2021 in form of avalanche and delay after the portion of the Nanda Devi glaciers broke off, and it is the big effect of our global warming. Next slide, ma'am. Another thing, cyclones. We are seeing here. These cyclones are affecting our earth. These were the extremely sharp cyclone category storm of hit in Gujarat in 23rd year cyclone Tauktae. So it is the effect of our global warming. Next slide, ma'am. We are seeing Yaas, tsunami, so many things, so many, this is the name of so many disasters or in water current. So it is a relatively strong and very damaging tropical cyclone. There are so many cyclones. Earlier we have seen tsunami. Now we have seen Yaas, and in this, the relatively strong and very damaging tropical cyclone that made landfall in Odisha and brought a significant impact on West Bengal during late May 2021. In very recently, we have seen the effect of Yaas. So it is also effect of global warming and greenhouse effect. And these all are caused by human being or by us due to many pollutants, due to creation of the pollution. Next slide, ma'am. So we can say what you can do to help stop global warming. You can see there are so many points. So first of all, we have seen I am talking with you. So plantation is the most important, and after that stop plastic, reuse, reduce and recycle. These three words are essential for the save our planet. Means reuse plastic, means use such plastic that we can use again and again. So reuse plastic, shopping bag, recycled glass jars, newspapers, tin cans, etc. So we can reuse and reduce. Try to minimize the use of plastic and reduce, reuse, and next, try having a compost heap in your yard. If you have land, so you can put your garbage, kitchen garbage, etc. in your yard. So that will create manure for your plants, and that will be helpful for you. And use both sides of paper. You people are wasting so much papers and old copies you are throwing in dustbin. So use each and every papers In old copies also, you can do rough on that. You can practice on that paper, any mathematics, science, literature, anything you can write and do practice on that paper. And you have to use both sides of papers. So it will be helpful for our planet. Suggest that your parent buy a fuel smart card. Smart car means he buy CNG. Nowadays, electric cars are coming, but at present, CNG are using for the your vehicle that is not fossil fuel and that is eco-friendly for us. And next point, plant trees. Don't keep the TV, VCR, and DVD on standby mode. Keep light off when you are not in the room. Consider public transportation alternatives. You can do pooling. If you are going in same place, all family members are taking one car. So you can go along with your parents or all elders and younger brother, sister, uncle, auntie. If you are going in same place, you can do pooling. So it will be helpful for our planet Earth. Insulate your home by fill up the dishwasher before using it. Wash clothes in cold and warm, not hot water. So these are some points that will be helpful for us to protect our planet and decrease the temperature of Earth. Means we can save our Earth from the global warming. Next point, ma'am. Go green. Go green. Nowadays, it is a very important name. Go green. Green energy. Do you know what is the green energy? Green energy means solar energy. Nowadays, it is a very much using in big factories. We are using in houses also. So many people's here, you children's, you have also, you have seen in roof so many the solar energy draper like glass like material or so many places. So go green for the energy, for the clothes, for the use paper bags. Don't use plastic bags. These are the big source of green energy, and you can also do so many things for the green planet. Next slide, ma'am. Why go green? With your cleaning benefits means you can use green colors. So what is the benefits? Benefits. Due to go green, we can save our plants, we can save our biodiversity of the animals, we can save biodiversity of the plants. And that's the when we will use green energy, green fuel, these all will help to protect our planets. Next slide, ma'am. Yeah, next slide, ma'am. Thank you. Thank you, Mitra. Thank you.
Okay, now.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you, ma'am.
Yeah, thank okay, you, Mrs. Arya, for enhancing knowledge and addressing us. There are a few set of questions that are asked by the kids, so if you could kindly answer them.
Yes.
The first question is from Renisha. How has COVID-19 affected the environment?
Yeah, COVID-19 was the healer of the environment. COVID-19, we can say COVID-19 was the ointment for the environment. Why? During the COVID-19, it was lockdown. And due to lockdown, vehicle was in the house. We have not used fossil fuel and not creating so much pollution. So COVID-19 was helpful for the protection of our earth and our planet. So lockdown definitely has played a great role in bringing ecological back to normally to great extent. Okay?
Okay, ma'am. The second question is by Anusha. When was the first ozone hole discovered?
First ozone hole was discovered in 1985. In 1985, scientists have seen, and particularly CAMS, yani ki Chemical Assessment Societies, they have seen there was so much thinning of the ozone layer. And in first, in 1985, a particular Montreal, I'm missing some, yeah. So in 1985, it will comes in first.
All right. Then the third question by Uzair, it is, what is the difference between good and bad ozone layer?
Yeah, ozone layer. We have seen ozone layer was good for us. Greenhouse gases are good for us. But high in height in the atmosphere, it is good, but ozone layer in the lower level, in our surroundings, ozone layer is the bad because it will create so much problem in our respiratory system, in our respiration. So ozone layer is bad in lower level, and in high altitude, yeah, in high atmosphere, it is good for us.
Okay. Then what, according to you, is the biggest environmental threat?
Okay. Big environmental threat is the so many factors are the environmental threat, but there are few like climate change. And due to climate change, species extinction, so many species are extincting due to change of the climate, and air water pollution, natural resources, disappearance or disaster, and deforestation, and due to that, soil degradation is also the big are a big challenge or a biggest environmental threat. So we can say climate change is the big threat. Due to that, all these are being.
Okay. Then the next question is from Ibrahim. It is, can the ozone layer repair itself?
Yes, ozone layer is repairing itself. And we are seeing our society, our Chemical Assessment Society, they reported ozone layer is shrank to its smaller size on record to last visit. Scientists have seen ozone layer is healing day by day. So it is a good news for us, and we are aware for the environment. And if we will do like this, so we will keep healthy and neat and clean our environment, and naturally ozone layer are healing day by day.
Okay. Then the next question is from Mohammed Ghazi. It says that, how are the carbon dioxide levels measured in the atmosphere?
Yeah. How was the carbon dioxide? There are so many things. The carbon dioxide are also measured by the CAMS agencies are also doing this work, and they are measuring the carbon dioxide in the atmosphere.
Okay. Then the next question by Dyumna Shah, it is, is plastic recyclable?
Plastic, there are two types of plastic. some plastic are recyclable and some are not recyclable. There are thickening that will depend upon the thickening, because plastics are a polymer. Polymers means so many monomers makes polymer, and polymer are recyclable if they will high density, and low density polymers are not recyclable. So that's why we have to use recyclable plastic, okay, not very thin plastic, and very thin plastic are banned nowadays.
Okay, thank you so much, Mrs. Arya, for addressing us.
Okay, thank you so much. Thank you so much for giving this opportunity. And at this time, I am in a village here, Gajbir, and these are the classroom, and examination is going on. I am sitting in a classroom that is vacated. So thank you so much.
Thank you, Mrs. Arya, for taking out your precious time, you know, and addressing our kids on such an informative topic. It was a pleasure to have you. Thank you from the BHIS team. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much. Okay.
Thank you. Now, children, I would just request you to please give your feedback before three. Please do give the feedback of the session. Thank you so much.